Hello, Canyon ISD family, coming to you today on March the 25th. And as you know, we've started a chat feature on our website, canyonisd.net. And the top chats that we've been getting, first one is, when do assignments begin, when does instruction begin? And that begins on Monday, March the 30th. That's when instruction begins. The second leading chat context that we get has to do with device pickup and devices, and we're going to answer that today. So we'll get to that in just a moment, but want to share with you a reminder that we have meals Monday through Friday, 11 to 1. They're available at 4 schools for curbside pickup, and then these locations for where our buses drop off. And I learned today that 1,980 meals were served today, so we're continuing to serve more of our families, and we hope that that's a good help for you as far as meals available. Some things we're going to talk about today, device pickup. This is for students who requested, when you talk to your teacher in, on Monday or Tuesday and requested a device, those are the orders we're trying to fill. This is primarily kindergarten through eighth grade. High schools have their own device. We're called a one-to-one or one-to-one high school campus, and that means they already have a device. So kindergarten through eighth grade, if you requested a device and said that you did not have something available, we need to fill those first. For those families who have multiple children, understand that we need to fill those requests first, and then if we have some available, we might be able to accommodate the others. No promises there. The pickup, though, is Thursday from 3 to 7 at the school campus. At the school campus tomorrow from 3 to 7. The next thing that I will share with you is in a day or two, we'll have this available on our website. It's called School at Home. And School at Home Parent Guide helps you as a parent. What do I need to do? What are my steps? So this is a pretty thorough guide. It explains things for you, but at the same time, we're always available in that online chat. And to talk further about that regarding internet and devices, I want to welcome Chris Norton. Chris is our Director of Digital and Academic Innovation, and he's going to share with you, well, what about the website and how we're going to have lessons happening? So Chris, come join us, please.
Thank you, Dr. Flusche.
We are so excited about our new School at Home program, and we know that there are lots of questions, some concerns, maybe some anxiety, but we want you to know that we're going to try to provide as much information as we possibly can to you to make this process as easy as possible. So we want to show you some different things that we have on hand to help you while you're at home. The first one is we do have a CISD website, and we have an online chat feature where I will show you in just a second. But down in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen, you will find a chat box. You can ask any questions that you have, and we'll be sure to answer those for you there. We also have the website hotspot.cisd.us. So if you need help trying to figure out how you're going to get internet at home, that's the website to go to figure out how you can do that so that your kids have internet access during this School at Home program. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and take you to the CISD website, and we'll show you the helpful features that we have there. You can notice that I have my chat box here. You can open that box up. Just begin typing your question, and then somebody will be on there to help you with that question, get the answers that you need. Also, beginning on Friday, that's when our site really is going to go live. And so as you scroll down, you may not see it now, but you will on Friday, this big banner that says Access School at Home. That's what you're going to click on to go to our School at Home website. You'll notice as soon as you go to it that we have our campus School at Home lessons. This is where you're gonna click on your child's campus to have access to the lessons that they're gonna work through throughout our School at Home program. So I'm gonna take you to one of our websites, and that's our Lakeview Elementary site. So if my student attends Lakeview Elementary, I'm just gonna click there, and immediately I have access to their lesson plans. You'll notice that it's done by grade level on our elementary websites. Junior highs and high schools are going to be a little bit different, and you're really going to be looking at more links by subject area. So when you click on the subject area, that'll take you to their lesson plans. So if my student is a first grader at Lakeview Elementary, they'll just click on the link there, and it'll open up the first grade at home lesson site so that your students can get the activities that they need, the work that they're gonna work through. It's gonna have some upcoming events, helpful links, so anything they need through this process is gonna be there and available to them. Another great site that we have on our website is if you can go back, you can always go back to the home page here by clicking on home. But then we also have this parent-student training resource page, and this is just great links to kind of help you answer your questions. If your students are trying to get on Google Classroom, we have training videos for both students and parents to figure out how to solve those questions. We also have training videos for Seesaw. And then the Parent Quick Start Guide that Dr. Flusche showed you earlier is there, as well as some online meeting etiquette that would be great for you and your students to read and to go through. So as we go back to our accessing school at home, remember that is going to happen on Friday. We can't tell you enough how excited we are, how hard our teachers have been working, and how ready we are to see your kids once again at home. Thank you very much. Have a great day.